Anchar, пустыни чахлый и скупой, на почве зноем раскаленной, Анчар, как грозный часовой, стоит один во всей вселенной.
Upon the barren desert sands, on soil parched by summer's curse, Anchar, dread century stands, all alone in the universe.
Природа жаждущих степей его в день гнева породила, и зелень мертвью ветвей, и корни ядом напоила.
There nature in the thirsty plain one day in wrath brought forth the thing, and to each root and leafy vein it made a deadly poison cling.
Яд каплет сквозь его кору, к полудню растопясь от зною, и застывает в вечеру густой прозрачную смолою.
The venom oozes down the bark, turned liquid by the blazing sun, and then congeals amid the dark into a thick, transparent gum.
К нему и птица не летит, и тигр не идет, лишь вихрь черный на древо смерти набежит и мчится прочь уже тлетворный.
Upon that tree no bird will light, no tiger come. The wind's black breath will circle round the tree of blight, then speed away, now laced with death.
И если туча оросит, блуждая лист его дремучий, с его ветвей уж ядовит, стекает дождь, песок горючий.
And should a wayward cloud its dew upon those drooping leaves bestow, the branches drip a fatal brew upon the burning sand below.
Но человеку человек послал к Анчару властным взглядом, и тот послушно путь потек, и к утру возвратился с ядом.
But once a man dispatched a man with baleful look into that waste, and he obeyed, and off he ran to bring the poison back in haste.
Принес он смертную смолу, да ветвь с увядающими листами, и пот по бледному челу струился хладными ручьями.
He brought the pitch upon a bough whose yellowed leaves had curled and died, and on his pale, stricken brow a chilling sweat poured down and dried.
Принес и ослабел и лег под сводом шалаша на лыке, и умер бедный раб у ног непобедимого владыки.
And having brought it, he grew weak, and lay beneath the vaulted tent at his mighty sovereign's feet, the wretched slave, expired, spent.
А князь тем ядом напитал свои послушливые стрелы, и с ними гибель разослал к соседям в чуждые пределы.
And in the venomed sap, the king dipped arrows for his warrior bands, and sent destruction near and far, upon the men of other lands.
This was on Char by Alexander Pushkin.
Thank you. And Emma Goldman writes in 1915,
out of service. energy.
If for no other reason, it is out of surplus energy that militarism must act to remain alive.
Or create one
artificially.
Thank you.
United States Title Code 8, Aliens and Nationality. Chapter 12, Immigration and Nationality. Subchapter 2, Immigration. United States Code 1324A1AVI.
the incompetent ruling class by underthrowing it from the toes up and immediately implementing the 1,000 alternatives to the destructive habits of capitalism.
He has 10,000 men.
Politics must abandon its traditional war and weapons preoccupations.
And when they're only halfway up, they're neither up nor down.
And make the severe health issues of our one and only Mother Earth and her Earthlings its primary concern.
Thank you.
This is a never-minded sermon. In Deutschen, Oratorio. The British kids verse says, never mind it. But, micro sisters and brothers who all need each other and all faith, feed and live of the same source. Unthinkable is at hand, and naked life runs in the streets, screaming.
At 7:30 p.m., which will be the beginning of our July and August summer programming. We will have Friday night shows throughout July and August at 7:30 p.m. right here at the papier-mâché Cathedral. Also in July and August, starting next Sunday, we will perform the Diagonal Life Circus and Pageant down in the circus field at 3 p.m. We will now serve bread and aioli out in the backyard, and the Bread and Puppet Press Store, Museum, and Cheap Art Bus will be open for your perusal. Lastly, we here at Bread and Puppet still believe in one great nation, and that's the donation. So if you did not see a hat on your way in, please feel free to visit one on your way out. Thank you.
What does it mean?
They would be something.